三宝兴法主讲者五静妙翻译者
Mr. Jerome William McCarthy Index
目录
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Tao
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道
Chapter 2 What is the Tao
第二章蛇魔是道
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures
第三章何谓三宝
Chapter 4 Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar
第四章为什么引宝要立愿
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the Tao
第五章为什么要力求道愿
Chapter 6 How to save human beings
第六章如何求度众生
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Tao Ladies and gentlemen I would like to extend my heartiest congratulations to you for this is your most auspicious dayToday you have received the Tao which is the ultimate aim of existence. All of the Buddhas and saints attained the Tao in the past and, by transcending the limitations of birth and death, have become immortal. That which you have received today is the same Tao. Formerly,One who intended to receive the Tao had to abandon worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to resign his high position, leave his family and go to the remote mountains to seek a master who would transmit the Tao to him.After much suffering he would gradually perfect his conduct, purify his mind and heart and perform many good deeds. For his sincerity, God would send Buddha to transmit the Tao to him. Under such conditions a person able to succeed was hard to find.During that period the Tao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to another.
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道各位先生太太小姐首先让我衷心地恭喜你们因为今天是你们大喜的日子今天你们得了道道是至宝，道超出了一切。每一位古圣先贤佛祖皆于古代求得天道，故他们能超出生死之界限而永存。今天你们所得的道即同他们其实所得的道一样。在古时人要得到必须弃他在世界上所拥有之一切与享受。假如他是一位皇帝也必须弃他的江山。假如他是一位大他必须舍弃他的爵离开家人入深山寻访能够指点他途径。传授大道给他的名师在他经历了千辛万苦之后同时已将凡心修炼成佛心并已达至圆满之行为以及做了许多善事在他至诚之下终于感动上天之心派天佛来指点传授大道给他在如此之情况下成功者非常稀少在那时道是由一代祖师秘传给下一代祖师
Today we need not go to the remote mountains in order to cultivate ourselves. We may find the means to do so in our own environment. Therefore we must take full advantage in our fortunate circumstances because we are in close proximity to the Tao. Why is the Tao so accessible to us at this time? It is because mankind is facing great calamities which signal the destruction of the human race. What is the cause of these calamities in this modern age? Most people blindly worship technical science and neglect spiritual harmony. They believe that the power of mankind can surpass nature and that science is almighty and can solve all human problems. It would seem as though conscience or soul are only religious terms and had no real existence. Most people do not recognize their true selves, which are indestructible and immortal. Actually, the true self is the master of the mortal body. Today most people have lost their consciences, harming others in order to benefit themselves. Those evils which human beings are now committing will cause great disasters, the likes of which had never been witnessed before. This will be the final calamity in which the human race, the immortals of space, and the ghosts in hell will all be destroyed.
然而现在我们不需要到深山去，而我们亦莫修行，何以我们能如此容易就得到？这是因为时代不同了。现在人类面对劫难之来临，末劫就要来到，末劫将会毁灭全人类。劫难是怎样造成的？原因是在此新世纪，多数的人们不盲目崇拜科学，而不注重心灵的完善。他们相信人类的力量能超出大自然，科学是高于一切，科学是万能，科学能解一切人类之问题。而良心、灵性仅是宗教之名词，它永不能实现。人们不认识真理，真理是我们之良心、道心、真我本体，它不不灭，万古长存。它是主持我一生之主人翁。如今世上的众生，大多数失去了真正的良心，他们造一切之罪恶，因此造成了空前绝后之浩劫。我们称它为末劫。在此浩劫中，不仅全世界的众生，同时起天的大仙、地府的鬼魂都要受劫灭。
However, God, of whose essence we are created, is merciful and compassionate and does not desire that the good people be destroyed along with the evil ones. So God has provided that the Tao be disseminated among mankind and has sent the great teachers, Buddha Shikun and Bodhisattva Yui, to rescue the three kinds of beings, the immortals of space, human beings, and the ghosts in hell, so that they may return to heaven together. Buddha Shikun and Bodhisattva Yui are under the command of God and are responsible for transmitting the Tao to the three kinds of beings. Their duty is to manage the work called the Last Salvation. This salvation is formless and soundless, and the transmission is performed without preaching. It directly points out the original major conscience or soul of mankind in order that people may realize their true nature and thereby become enlightened.
然而是我们灵性的至高无上之母亲上帝是非常的慈悲，一不忍善恶俱焚，因此降下真道定海明师济公活佛与月慧菩萨降世，挽救三淘气天之大天，世界的众生、地府的鬼魂同返天堂。我们师尊师母二位老大人奉老母的命令，真传真守，普渡三淘。他们的责任是办理末后一收缘大事，不立文字，教外别传，实指人心，直指人人固有之良心。灵性是人们见自性而成佛。
When the last calamity arrives, nothing can save mankind except the true way, which is the vow sent from God. That is why the vow is widely propagated today to save good people. Ancient people first cultivated themselves and then received the Tao. But today we receive the Tao first and then cultivate ourselves. Therefore,After we have received the Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then we shall automatically be safe from danger, escape from calamities, avoid reincarnation and become saints and Buddhas.
当末劫临头时，没有任何其他方法可以解救众生，除了上帝所降下的唯一之道，因此现在大道普渡善男信女。古人是先修后的，先修道然后才得道，现在我们是先的后修，因此得道以后，我们要真正修道，将来自然能逢凶化吉，堕劫底难超生了死，成圣成佛。
Although it is easier for modern people to receive the Tao than it was for past generations, the ability to receive the Tao also depends on each person's condition and background. Today you receive the Tao because you had an affinity with our temple and you and your ancestors had performed many virtuous acts. Possibly you were cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These conditions allow you to have an affinity for the Tao. Without this affinity you would never receive it.
虽然今人比古人更易得道，然而亦是各凭各知，根基缘分。今天你们得道皆因与我有缘，前世有行善积德，祖先有德，也许前世有修过儒大宗教或其他宗教，因此使你们今天有缘得道，否则将永不能得到。
Chapter 2 What is the Tao, ladies and gentlemen? You have received the Tao today, but what did you actually receive? What is the Tao? The Tao is the source of everything. Tao is the creator and master of the universe. Tao is God, the supreme power.Before the earth and sky existed, before the creation of the universe, the Tao existed. After the universe is annihilated and nothing remains, the Ba will continue to exist and to create and control a new universe. The Ba is limitless, invisible and formless. It cannot be seen, heard, smelled or touched and is beyond the power of human comprehension. Ba activates everything. Yet we cannot see its action. It works without effort, yet nothing left undone. Man usually calls it nature. Nothing can exist without the Tao because everything depends on it. Ba is God and our soul issues from God's essence. We are God's children.
第二章蛇魔是道各位今天已经得到就近得的是蛇魔蛇魔是道道是天地人万物之母道是宇宙之本源创造者地及主宰者道上帝道至尊至贵之神当天地还未生之前一切都未有之前道一天存在的当天地毁灭后道不毁灭道能再生天地人万物天地人万物生成了道其中主宰道非常奥妙道无形无相视而不见听而不闻不可嗅不可捉摸道超出了人们的想象力而不思议亦不可言说一切皆是道所为然而我见不到道的动作道是无为而为的然一切莫不是道所为人们常称它为自然假若无道任何一物不能存在因为一切都依靠道而的存道上帝我们之灵性是上帝所赐我们是上帝之儿女上帝是我们之天
When we speak of the creator of the universe we call it Tao When we speak of the ruler of everything we call it natural lawWhen we speak of the animating and controlling principle of our being, we call it soul or conscience. When we speak of the creator of our soul, we refer to the Heavenly Mother in Chinese she is called Lao Mu. All and all the above are one and the same.
当我们从它作为宇宙之本源而言称它为道在它作为一切之主宰而言我们称它为理当它在我们体内使我们生存定之配肉体时我们称它为灵性或良心因为它赋予我们本性我们称它为老这些名称虽异而其意相同皆指同一物而言
Now, what you have actually received is the Tao Tao is everybody's true self Today you have been initiated by the teacher and the door of your mind has been opened Now you are able to understand that the body is not your true self. The body is controlled by the Tao within you.
现在你们得的就是道，道是每一个人的真我。今天你们已得名师指点，开了心窍。现在你认识了肉体并非真正的你。而灵性才是真正的你那会无形无相的然而在支配你的身体的灵性才 才是真正的你自己。
While you are alive, your soul dwells within your body. As soon as the soul leaves your body, you are dead. Your soul is from God, but your physical body is from your parents. You already had the Tao within you yet did not realize it. Therefore,You have had to search for it and have now been fortunate enough to find a teacher who was able to transmit it to you. Previously you believed that the physical body was your true self and behaved accordingly. You were selfish, committing misdeeds, acts of violence, and overindulging in physical pleasures.This condition repeatedly led you into a reincarnation and endless sufferings. Now you understand that your true self is not your physical body but only use the body as a vehicle. You are not limited to this physical body. You are boundless. You are the master of the universe because you have God's essence within you.You are full of mercy and love because you share of God's spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时，灵性在他体内，若灵性已离开他立刻就死亡，灵性附于天，而肉体由父母而来。因此，事实上我们已有道在身上，为何还要再寻求他，还要有点传师来传授？原因是我们已不认识他了。我们以为肉体真我而不知它原是假，因此我们变得自私，做了许多错事与罪恶。为了持此色身享受如此，使我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性，而我们已不是仅限于此肉身，我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰，因我们的灵性与老是一体，我们的本性充满了慈悲与爱心，因我们是老之分灵。然而现在人们都失去了这些品性，亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我良心。
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures? Today you have received the three treasures. A. The heavenly portal B. The divine mantra C. The symbolic seal A. The first treasureThe heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony, is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience which is eternal and indestructible.2. The portal of birth and death. The heavenly portal is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way? 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says,Heaven is 108,000 miles away. These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away, but with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has plumped out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经？天，你们所得之至宝义可称为三宝，一玄关，二口诀，三合同。以第一宝玄关，玄关玄妙莫测之门。玄关点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心，它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点生死之门户，玄关是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰，谁能出不由户，何莫由斯道也。三点通天，大陆国经云，七天十万八千里，此是譬喻，亦成佛是不义之耻，因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。
The main entrance, the heavenly portal is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher,Your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, A. The eyes, B. The ears, C. The mouth, D. The nose, E. The navel, F. The vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. The eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. The mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. The nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee,etc. The navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. Vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，此门关闭了。假如我们不欲名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体，它只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口抵住其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生方为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类。二由眼而出者，来生方为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类。三由口而出者，来生方为食生之动物，如鱼虾之类。四由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如苍蝇、蜜蜂之类。五由肚脐而出者，来生当为平庸之人。六由顶门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。 上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱乎生死之苦。见传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路，我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回受苦。但是我们必须要真修，否则玄关虽开，我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶，灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。五点。
In the Bible, Matthew 14.